listening to Jan Talk.
Go.
We in the jungle, baby.
Number one.
Yo, yo, yo. It's the Jan Talk Podcast with your boy, Mike J. And Trav. Shell and Groove Jewel is not with us today. And as you can see, we're live on scene at the BBU second annual block party. And we're going to get y'all a couple of live interviews, dope content. And now y'all been wanting to see us.
Us.
Yeah, you want to see us. You want to see how crazy we get. That's why I got the Robin shirt. Crazy is
crazy.
It's strange. You know what I'm saying? But yeah, we're going to get some interviews, get an insight on what's going on in Columbus. All these nice business owners coming out today. So we're going to interview them, see what they got for us and everything. Going to give them some questions. They're going to give us some answers. Y'all stay tuned. It's the Gintalkers Podcast. Yeah.
Hey guys, welcome. We are at our second annual business block party on behalf of Black Businesses United. I'm the president, Jessica Aldridge. This is my vice president, Christian Reliford.
What's going on?
So we're just here. We have local vendors setting up still. We're trying to put on an event for the community, of course. Come out, get you some good food, shop with some local vendors, and you know, just kind of take care of one another. That's what we do.
Absolutely. So make sure you come out and support. I know you're catching this. You might be a little bit late, but once again, this is our second annual block party free event. Let me emphasize once again, this is a free event. We're giving back to the community. So yeah, if you're a business owner, you get free headshots. We do have the legendary Foreign Life Photography out here. Mm-hmm. We have Davian Chester, the one and only, who has actually made his publications to Google. We have Love at First Bite. He is a local legend right now. We have Doris Daughter, who is actually up in a ride straight out of Phoenix City. We also have our teen resource event. I am one and only Mr. Trapping Healthy. We're bringing you fresh pressed juices. And also we have the legendary Jam Podcast as well. Yeah. So definitely make sure that you go and listen. Make sure you go and listen. Make sure you support, subscribe, and buy everything up.
Buy everything up.
Yeah.
So yeah, we're just doing this here for local vendors. Hopefully you can catch some great interviews with some of the vendors that are here. So they can talk to you a little bit about their brands, and we can, you know, create a network, because that's what we're here for at the end of the day. We're here to create a network between minority entrepreneurs so we can have people to lean on when needed.
Absolutely.
But yeah, that's what we're here for. Thank you for coming and doing your podcast. It's always exciting when you guys come out.
Yeah, we are. We love y'all. Invite us out, man. We appreciate y'all as well.
Absolutely.
Man, we appreciate y'all, man. But once again, we thank y'all because y'all didn't have to do so, but you definitely did it anyway.
Right.
And like I said, it's just all love forever. So we thank y'all so much.
Yes,
all
right.
Hey, we live at second annual BBU block party, and we are here with our first interview. And you can introduce yourself.
Hi, my name is Tasha Magana, and I'm the owner and chef of Doris's Daughter Private Chef and Catering.
Our platform again. You can tell our audience what it is you do and what it is you serve and all that good stuff.
Well, we provide. Caterings. We also do like private chef services where we come to your home and cook for you. Like we have like an intimate setting or anything like that. We also plate specials Tuesdays, Thursdays, Fridays, and Sundays where I have a video that I post every day for on Facebook and Instagram on my page. Let you know what we're having. Tuesdays, Thursdays, and Sundays is just dinner. On Friday we just serve lunch and
Sound like I've been.
We've been in business about 3 months now. So we're barely new. We're just trying to get our name out there. At the block party today, we're doing pineapple rolls, chicken or shrimp with either jerk or teriyaki sauce, and then you have a cilantro lime sauce or a yogurt sauce with a little top.
So where are you located?
We are located in Phoenix City. We went out of our home. She wasn't my cooking inspiration, that was my grandmother, but my mother was a really big entrepreneur. She had they have something also for, you know, generational wealth. My children.
Yeah. That's good. Great backstory.
Yes, it's been challenging. I went from working a full-time job. I've been working for like 6 years. So this is my passion, but I went from working a full-time job to just basically this. And I didn't realize how much financially it was going to cost me. So now I'm like, I'm looking at brands and owns, trying to help them start a business, work full-time this time. So yeah, that's the challenge. And then like, it's just me doing it. So I'm the cook. Cooking
the food, delivering the food,
taking the orders, you know, so it's really like, it's
challenging, but
my family can help when they can, but, you know.
Nice thing about that, you get
100%
on profit.
Yeah, right, that's right, that's right.
So is there anything in the future that you have in store that you want, like maybe speaking into existence?
A restaurant, that's what I'm speaking into, that's what I want. I want to have a restaurant that everybody comes to. Famous people, regular people, everybody comes out and just enjoys the food because I make my food good.
Yeah, we want to thank you for coming on our platform. We want to give you plugs out. What people can contact you
with? You can reach me on Facebook and Instagram at Doris Daughter FS. Also, my email is DorisDaughterFoodService@gmail.com. Our phone number is 6528.
I'm sorry. 6528. Yeah, we appreciate you coming on and being our first interview.
All right. Well, I appreciate you guys. Thank you so much for your time.
All right. All right. Thank you.
Yo, yo, yo. It's the Gin Talk Podcast. We're out here at the BBU. BBU Block Party. Well, I'm interviewing all the black business owners. And would you like to introduce yourself, ma'am?
Yes, I'm Shana St. Rutledge.
Alrighty. So what you got for us today? What are you out here to sell?
Today at the Block Party, I have three of my signature drinks. One is the Casamigos Margarita.
Oh, man, I'm still sick from that from last night. Not your purse, but the Casamigos.
Right, the Casamigos. Yeah, it'll do it to you. And so that's why I actually had a signature perfect margarita. So I added, of course, a little cockiness to it with the Casamigos. I have my strawberries on top of me, which is my signature strawberry Hennessy. And exotic water rumble. And that's just an escape away from Columbus, giving you the clear water, but it has a rumble of rum.
So for y'all want to go to Jamaica or somewhere like that, get on the beach. Definitely,
I'm gonna take
y'all.
You to the island in the bottom.
It's an island, man.
Tell us about your origin story and everything. What made you want to start your own business with drinks and everything?
Okay. So growing up, I actually grew up with a family that loves to have parties and like to entertain. And one of my favorite aunts, she actually was the unofficial bartender of the family. So part of it was because I admire her, but I've also had a passion for just entertaining. So I actually worked in the nightclub, on the nightclub scene, and I did it a little bit private parties. But when the pandemic actually hit, I did a full lunch of Savory Sips and Tipsytails being a mobile bartender, because I would run into my customers from the clubs that, because we were shelter in place, they wanted something to drink at home. So it started with me just having a little bottle, giving it to them, letting them take it home and enjoy it. So then I flourished into full-fledged mobile bartender.
Okay.
So what, personally, what's your favorite drink is?
My personal favorite is actually what we call a Cadillac. It's not on the menu, but it's a version of a Hennessy margarita.
Oh, man. Wow. So they're going to put it right.
And that came from my actual bar partner. She's not here today because, as well, of course, we still bartend. So she actually is at Applebee's bartending. But Pilp, you can also find her usually with me. She's a known bartender in the city, but that's one of her signatures that I feel in love with. So. We do bring you the Cadillac.
Mm-hmm. We've been asking all these owners out here this one question. It's called the Speaking Into Existence. So in the future with your business, what would you like to have?
I would like for my business to at least be booked and busy every single weekend. Every single weekend. I mean, I have a few weddings coming up this summer. Of course, wedding season is coming up. Yeah. So I am thankful that I have a few weddings coming up. But I want every weekend to be booked and busy.
That's all I'm talking about.
Yeah, make everybody happy, enjoy a little tips.
Yeah. You know.
A little slump. Do you make any drinks with gin in? We gin talk podcast. So you make any drink with gin in?
I do make drinks with gin.
For old people don't.
However, yeah, it depends on. So usually when I'm booking a party, it depends on. Now, if it's that age group, I got to have it on the menu.
Yeah.
It's a classic. Yeah. I want to say, it's a classic.
Got some old soul in it.
Look, classic soul. Not
Sour green.
Yeah.
Time and everything. You gonna have plug up everything on your social medias, everything where they can find you?
Yeah, you can find me on Facebook personally as Shana St. Rutledge. The Facebook business page is Savory Sips and Tipsytails by ST, as well as on Instagram, it's Savory Sips and Tipsytails. And you can find me on TikTok as Shake Shit Up Rut.
Yo, it's your boy Mike J with the Gintalkers Podcast. We're still going around in the BBU block party. Got this young gentleman right here. What's your name, young sir?
Davian Chester.
All right, Davian Chester. I see you got a lot of art right here. I heard you're real known. You did some art for Google and everything. That's real good, man. How you doing?
Thank you. Appreciate it.
So, how long you been doing art?
About 10 years. About 10, 12 years.
10 years. So was there any cartoons or anything that inspired you to do this?
Yeah, pretty much. Growing up, Cartoon Network, 90s Cartoon Network inspired me a lot. Mostly, though, you know, the lack of black cartoons that we had, it always inspired me through middle school and high school to, like, create stories featuring us. Mm-hmm. So that later inspired me to do, you know, just general stories, comics anyway, mm-hmm. with us. That's why my tagline is the black experience now, because okay. now I really love sharing the good, like bad, everything we go through.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. So is there any type of illustrator, any cartoon style art that you like, or that you like, that inspired you? Like, there's some people like that like the Ren and Stimpy style, like the Family Guy style, or the Boondock style, like anime and all that.
I wouldn't say a certain style that interests me, because I do like them all, and one of my like specialties is I'm able to do different styles anyway. They all really play a part, so I like mm-hmm. them all. And I'm actually now getting more into anime, so something too.
That's good. So can you? I'm looking at some of the arts right here. So right here, I see one that's real, real, real powerful. It says, "This is a man with depression, and this is also a man with depression." So you just go through like basically illustrate everything that goes on with black man or a black woman's life.
Yep, black
and that's
man,
the whole
black,
black experience and everything.
Yeah, from relationships to mental health, mm-hmm. You know, the Black Lives Matter movement, mm-hmm. Family relationships, all of it.
Yeah, mm-hmm. I'm seeing some of this stuff, like it could be a topic for podcasts and everything, where you say, can you be pro-black and also date outside the race, which is good. It could be good for, you know, a nice little episode cover and everything. So, and see, like, you have opinions, like some people have black art, but they'll put Goku and some J's and call it black art, and I see that's like an opinion, that's like a statement. Yeah. So it's more like you make statements and your opinions, or it's just on your mind, like what gets you going?
Yeah.
What?
I would say it's a combination of everything. I do love the opinions of from us. So I do create these conversation pieces to get everyone talking, mm-hmm. you know, and that inspires me too, because everyone, you know, they have their own view. And a lot of things can relate to them. So I love to generate discussions. A lot of it I agree. Some of it I disagree. It's just a general thing of everything.
And that's what art is.
Yeah.
You agree with it or you don't agree with it. So that's the whole thing with art. So another thing. So what in the future, I call this the speaking to existence. What in the future do you want to come out of your art and everything? What do you want?
I want my art more mainstream, so it can generate more topics, more discussions, more people would know what's happening, because a lot of people don't know what's going on. I would say, you know, get more views on my art, so that would go to my business too, so like I can create more black art for businesses, entrepreneurs, and just other creatives who just have visions and they want to bring it to life.
That's good. You ever getting into, also another question, are you getting into animation or anything? I thought about it.
It's been a debate going on for a long time, but mostly just illustration, graphic design, and animation. I'm liking those three loops.
That's good, man. In my opinion, if you went into the animation and had you a nice YouTube channel just to show a little shortcut, man, I swear to God, that'd be good, man. That'd be real dope.
I think so too.
That'd be real
dope.
It's in the books. Yes, sir. So what you doing out here for the block party? You doing prints? You doing anything?
I'm doing some prints that I've already made. And also just advertising my custom work, so I'm able to do graphic design and illustration for people.
All right. You mind if we get a little shout out?
So,
real, some dope pieces right here. Dope pieces, man.
Thank you. I appreciate
you. You just go ahead and showcase it.
Yeah, so I have different black beauty pieces, different illustrations that I'm selling. Usually, I'm just doing that, just cover different things, relationship, black beauty. Art that they could hang up in their homes. I have them in size 11 by 17, and I'm trying to do 18 by 24. So, just some lovely work.
Real beautiful, man.
Thank you.
Hey, man. That goes to show you, man, when you work hard, things happen. Good things happen, man. Hey, man, I really appreciate you, man. Appreciate your time and everything, man. Go ahead and check it out. Go ahead and plug your plug in, sir.
Social media, Real Toons, all across all social media. You can find me Real Toons, or you can type my name in, Davian Chester.
All righty. Thank you, sir. Have a good day now.
How you doing, sir?
Man, holding it down. Beautiful weather. Can't complain.
It's summer. I know you got some new
stuff. I got some new stuff, man. I'm
talking to you, man.
I got the Be Good Clothing Generation 2 logo. I don't know if y'all seen these the last time we was out, but I revamped the logo, somewhere a little bit more streamlined, something that I felt that I could believe in. Then I got the BGC Dad Hat Tray. I got one of these joints right here. Then I also got the BGC Varsity Basketball Shorts. Basic. Or my customizing, never know. All types of flavors of walks of life.
So, yeah. Right in time for the summer and the spring, spring and summer.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. You know, we interviewed before, but we're gonna let the people know for the new audiences out there. What made you start off your business?
Man, I had a couple of ideas that had been sitting in my head, and I was like, what better time than 2020 to try to make some change? Get whatever ideas I had in my head, I got to get them out. First time everybody was able to sit at the house, chill, think whether it was good thoughts or bad thoughts. First time in recent memory that we could sit and collect our thoughts and figure out how to execute it.
Me personally, I enjoyed the pandemic, to be honest.
I still got the mint one too. So just hit up the website, www.begoodclothing.com. That's 1B, word good, clothing.com. Oh man, like I said at the last interview, man, I want to get to a point where I'm just out living life at random and I see somebody with my clothing. That at least will let me know that I'm on the right direction.
I love you, man. Feel good, look good.
Right, yes, sir. Everything. When in doubt, make sure you be good, man.
I promise. Great slogan.
Oh, yeah.
Yes, sir. So, is there anything you want to plug out? Any shout-outs or any plugs,
man? Oh, man, shout out to BBU, man. Black Business United. This is a dope organization. If you're looking for some kind of support, my black people, my entrepreneurs, my business owners and what have you, anybody that's wanting to get into that type of space, Black Businesses United, you can join, man. Very open, very welcoming. Got any ideas and questions? I'm pretty sure there's at least 1 to 5 people that's there to be able to answer these questions.
Yeah. So jumping out, though, BBU is like a safety net.
Yes, sir.
Just in case you slip and fall, we got you.
We got you.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, you can find me on Instagram and Facebook at Be Good Clothing. That's 1B, word good, clothing, smash it together. Website BeGoodClothing.com. Yeah man, it is what it is. Social media. I'll let you work.
Appreciate you, man.
Yeah. Gintalk Podcast
at the BBU Block Party. Right now, we're interviewing all these black business owners. Today, we got a special guest with us. Can you introduce yourself now?
Hi, my name is Natasha, owner of Ethereal.
Tell us what. Your business?
A little bit of everything. I have dominoes. I create with resin, which is rolling trays, ashtrays. I have hoodies, hats, shirts. I do custom work. Just a little bit of everything. Kind of dabbling whatever's needed.
Okay. So what's inspired you to start your business?
Honestly, just being locked up, wanting to be creative. Just kind of getting tired of just sitting in the house and, you know, eating hot wings every day. So, you know, hot wings and Popeye's chicken sandwiches every day. So. Just had to do something.
Yeah. Right. Has anybody inspired you to do your creations or anything? You got some nice art.
Thank you. Well, you know, my husband's Bronson, so, you know, just seeing him just kind of be creative with his kind of sparked something in me. So after a lot of research and just kind of seeing what I can do safely at the house, I found resin. And it's so versatile because you can do pretty much everything with it. So just based on that, I just started just creating whatever I just popped in my head. So yeah, that's pretty much it. Just wanted to do something handsy.
Yeah,
okay. Hands on. Yeah, definitely.
What's your signature item that everybody goes crazy? Mm. Or do you feel like you love making it work?
I would say sets. Like I got into making like the rolling trays and ashtray sets.
Yeah.
So I just think when you kind of pair things together, it kind of gives a person a little bit more versatility to make, you know, get an order. Got a few things that can switch and swap. Also, my coasters. Yeah. I think those are a good seller too. Cause, I mean, everybody needs coasters. You know, yeah. A little fancy, whatever, you know.
Don't mess the table up. Yeah.
Exactly. We adults. We don't need rings on our tables. Yeah. You know, so I think barrels are needed and versatile. So, and like I said, I do custom work. So if you got something you want to match your living room with, I can color match any color you want. So,
yeah.
Yeah,
definitely. So, in all y'all new homeowners, y'all need something to need a good interior design for your living room.
Right here.
Definitely.
Merchandise.
Oh yeah, that's real dope.
These are the sets I was talking about. So we got some sets right here, and this is actually a extra large ashtray. So. That could be used as a tray and an ashtray. So if you want something that can be most of usage, you have that.
Dominoes.
My coasters, like I said, we adults, no need no rings on your tables.
Yep.
And ashtrays, I have keychains, jewelry trays, and I forgot my hoodies, my shirt.
Okay.
So right here.
How long does it usually take you to make a product?
Normally just depends on the size of product, because resin does have to cure. So a few days, but actually just really depends on the materials that I have to use to make it. Different materials will slow down the curing time for the resin. So just really depends, but I'm back and forth about it a few days.
Is there been anything challenging?
Yeah. Because, you know, I'm a wife, I'm a mother, I have a full-time job, I'm in school, so just staying motivated, just keep pushing despite how you may be feeling at the time, just knowing that, you know, just because I don't sell something today, there's always tomorrow, maybe do a little more promoing or, you know, whatever, but just to keep going.
Like they always say, don't take 100 a year.
Exactly. And this is only my second year.
Yeah.
So I'm still learning everything, so just being open to learning, and like I said, just keep pushing, staying motivated.
Here's a million-dollar question. Called us to speak into existence. In the future, how would you want to have your business grow forward? How do you want your business to be? Shop, have a name, like a tree or something like that. I'm just saying, so you speak into existence, it's gonna happen.
What's crazy, a lot of people think sideways. My actual full-time job, I absolutely love my career, so I don't ever see myself stopping doing that to do this full-time, but my speaking to existence would be the fact that I have enough mental capacity to maintain both, to be successful in my level of success, not anyone else.
Yeah, it's great.
My level of success, and just to keep pushing it, and, you know, have a little ethereal glow in everybody's house. Yeah. Whether it's a keychain, coaster set, or whatever, just spread the word, and I'm all about
several different events and and find us at teenresource5.org. Let's see. Also at teenresource5.com. I'm sorry. But .com is the one you want to go to for that list of volunteer opportunities. So we do several different things. We have, Reach for the Sky program over the summer will help provide rides for local teens to the polls if you want to vote. But we also, if you will come volunteer with us here and there, we can give you rides to work if you need them. So I mentioned the garden. That's another volunteer opportunity. If you're interested in the local community garden on MLK, come out. Reach out to us. We have opportunities all the time. We need help out there too. I'm trying to thank y'all for doing so much. We definitely need help from our adults. We need y'all to come out and help teach these life skills to these kids. We got an upcoming pilot called Going Live to do that. So I could go on and on. But I just want y'all to know that our community needs y'all. So don't just sit back and watch these kids die. Come on.
So what you feel like the biggest, like, grab?
Well, a lot of kids kind of see through the fog. They see through all the, you know, costumes. They want you to tell it to them straight, you know what I'm saying? A lot of kids are into what they see online, unfortunately. You know, so most that you can link them to real life and what's happening in front of them, that helps a whole lot. Personalize, individualize your interaction with them. But it changes all the time. So we need teens to also come join our teen advisory board and help keep us fresh. Keep telling us what y'all into. Because, you know, we old. Growing up in Muskogee County, I learned early on the value of giving back and volunteering with the community. Not only for my own personal giving back, but people giving back and instilling in me. So just from early on, I really have always had a passion for this. I work for the state also for my 9-to-5 to do this. So it's, you know, I see it from our own front doors, but I also see it from, you know, and it's not a good representation. We got the flip script.
Like I said, I've seen the whole, like, I've seen everything. Kids, everything. Murder, all that.
Organization, because there's a small network of people out here trying to help these kids. We don't have enough volunteers, and it's hard to compete for funding with some of the other businesses and organizations that promote they help kids, but they're not helping the kids.
They think it's lame to do, so they don't want to do it, or they just do it for their own benefit.
So, you know, they're getting these grants, like the crime prevention one, that's in the city, and they're putting it towards initiatives that don't really involve kids, or maybe involve kids just a smidge bit, but it's not getting to the heart of the kids that are at risk. And we're hurting from it. How many of y'all know a kid that have, you know, have had an impact from some of the crime just this year? And how many people do you know say things like, oh, that was such and such brother? Or that was, you know, that's, huh? homeboy little cousin out here doing all this. Yeah. You know who it is. But it's not necessarily about you telling them. It's about you reaching out to them.
Yeah, exactly. What's going on? What do you need?
Yeah. What do you need?
I've seen it all the time. You never know. Like you just said, kids have a hard time expressing themselves, especially on trucks. So you gotta bring it all the way down, strip it all the way down to just you and them.
Yeah. I have a little. Yeah. It's definitely a passion of mine. But like I said, we need more people out here opening their mouths about how they feel, not just shaking their head and reposting it online. Like, y'all got to.
Yeah.
Like, y'all got to get out here and tell Lil Pooper, your car's been tripping. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like, you need to tell these people because we're losing our kids as a result of it. And they are the future.
Yeah, they are.
So, if you can, and I ain't going to talk too long, but. If you think about it, from when we were young and the things that were considered, you know, bad, when we were coming up to now, what you think our future gonna look like with this next generation coming up?
I don't even see it. Like, it's hard to say, it's bad to say this, but you don't look too promising.
You know, it's scary.
Yeah.
And that's scary than y'all saying it.
Yeah.
You understand what I'm saying? Because y'all are out here because y'all are the business leaders of our community.
Yeah.
And this is how you feel about our community.
Yeah.
So, we got to flip the script. So, you know, even if you got to join our organization and help give rides once or twice a month over the summer when kids need a ride to work.
Yeah.
It don't have to be, you know, everyday thing. We know everybody works. But that's how these kids gonna stay busy. A hot time for crime for them is in the summer. If they need a ride to work, they need a ride to go get an ID or a birth certificate or something, help them. Don't just sit back. Like, it's enough of that. It's enough of that. And you know, the reason why our organization does so much, the reason why we do so much, y'all, is because it don't take much. It does not take much. So, you know, even I try to encourage everybody, if you start an initiative with your own business, do that. Teach these kids how to start their own podcast. Y'all know how much men out here for them podcasts right now. Teach them.
Yeah.
Teach them that they could make it with a podcast before they can make it out here missing that goal, talking about they're going to be a basketball player.
Yeah.
Well, you ain't.
Yeah, you ain't
hit a layup and you can't do it. You know what I'm saying? So teach them the ins and outs of the different types of careers there are out there. Narrative that people, kids don't have to go to school. No, you don't have to go to school. You have to do something.
Yeah, do something. It's not gonna come to you.
You can't stop the conversation by you ain't gotta go to school. You keep that conversation going. You ain't gotta go to school. But you got to go.
If it's in that home, an item of mine is never free for us.
Yeah, say it again.
For real, so you keep, I'm here to say, keep busy, keep doing something.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, always keep doing. I think that was. I wish we had like a real community down here. So we teach these kids like podcasting, like all kind of media. Like you said, you gotta make a basketball, football, and all that other stuff. But even music, cause I know if I don't make the music, I guess I ain't. I gotta go into the street. So
and that's what they're into, the media. They wanna be famous.
Yeah.
Okay. They wanna be famous.
Yeah.
But for a lot of them, that's as real as it gets to them being famous. So, there's another organization that we partner with from time called Shoot Film, Not Guns.
Yeah.
They're local. They work with any kid that's really, and they teach them all the aspects of the behind the scenes of media.
Yeah.
Just gotta get out here.
Yeah.
So, guns out. You know, we got a lot going on, but you got to start somewhere.
Why not start here?
Yes, T345, y'all. We do have, you can find us on Facebook and Instagram. We do have one of our organizations, Ross and Strong. They post the most, so you'll probably, you know. But they're under us. It's a wrestling group here. They'll be competing this summer.
Yeah. The sun.
Goodbye.